How should financial institutions embrace digital to become more open for this digital future?
Yes, I think that banks need to honestly think by themselves on how they are approaching the relationship with their customer. It is about being more close to them to make this happen.
And what are you seeing today? I know you don't cover Brazil specifically, but what are you seeing in global basis and in terms of financial institutions embrace these digital trends and incorporating new services or releasing new products that should be really in aligned to this bank of future?
Yeah, I think that one of the major trends that we are seeing, it is about real-time payment services and mainly related to the cross-border real-time payment services, which means enabling customers to make payments anywhere at any time easily by using whatever means of channel, maybe a mobile, a social network or whatever. I think that's the major trend, let's say, from a retail perspective and actually what transaction banks globally from an international cash management perspective are looking at.
And do we have today banks that are effectively doing that?
Yes, we have some banks doing that. In we can say, for instance, in Sweden, in the UK, those markets that already have real-time payment services, for instance, like I mentioned before, they are currently innovating a lot to cope with the competitions from the new entrants, because the customers in and this is slightly different from a developed economy and developing economy. Maybe in a developed economy, the digitalization is more genuine, let's say, in terms of allowing digital services for their customers. Maybe in developing economies like Latin America or Asia, this is more focused on serving the unbanked or underbanked customers, right?
And how do you analyze the release of MetaCoins and their impact to financial institutions?
Well, we are seeing, let's say, MetaCoin platforms as at Gartner as part of the what we call the programmable economy. This is just one of the enablers that will allow a new area of doing business. However, this will be all the MetaCoins initiatives will be somehow the piece of innovation in this area will be related to how the regulators and from a compliance perspective, from the government perspective, will allow this new trends comes into the game. But definitely, we are seeing this as the new era of doing digital banking.
So do you think banks should embrace MetaCoins in order to be part of this new business? Otherwise, they're going to be just as cabs fighting with Uber, for example.
Yes, definitely. MetaCoin platforms, and when we talk about, that's why we tend to talk about MetaCoin platform and not specifically on Bitcoin specifically, because Bitcoin is just a currency, right? We are talking about embracing the technology which is underlying MetaCoin platform, so underlying the Bitcoin technology itself in terms of the distributed general ledger to use the tokens as a means of exchange of value, and also using the scripting language which will allow smart contracts, smart oracles, and if go further into the innovation for decentralized autonomous organizations.
And looking at all of these trends, in which stage do you think today financial institutions are? And in how many years do you think we are going to see this transformation?
We are seeing that this transformation will happen in the next 2 to 3 years, and that's why we are seeing an increased pressure in the financial institutions to be up to speed and innovate and transform themselves, as I showed it in the presentation earlier, as fast as possible, right?
And is there any start pointing that's going to push all this in transformation?
I think that this already started. I mean, this is not about when exactly. It's not about when. It is already happening. So it is a matter on how fast they do the transformation.